Welcome back to the channel, guys. Aaron here with Off the Scales Fishing. And today we are talking about my boat and all the things that I've done to it, customizations, you know, things like that over, you know, I don't know, maybe the last 2 or 3 years. So let's get into it. All right, guys, so this is, my boat is a 16-foot aluminum craft.
Crappie John is the model of this boat. I've had a lot of fun, you know, making this my own boat here. You know, as you can see, I put a ton of stickers up and down the sidewalls, or whatever you want to call them. And then, you know, I got my Off the Scales Fishing sticker there. And then stickers all up and down, you know, the sides over here. So it's been a lot of fun, you know, putting all the stickers and stuff on them. Got some stickers on the outside. All that good stuff. So, you know, well, I guess we'll just, you know, crank it up with, or start it off with the motors that I run on here. I got it set up right now, for an electric only, you know, I got a lot of watersheds and a couple juice spots out in Georgia that I fish that are all electric only, you know, fisheries, smaller, you know, reservoirs, stuff like that. And they all hold a bunch of big bass. So, you know, I'm kind of spoiled when it comes to that type of stuff. But I also, I guess we'll talk about the big motor at first here, you know, from like the bigger water that I fish. So let's go check it out. I run a little 9.9 Nissan motor right here. And when I have my boat set up for electric only, you know, I made a little, you know, mount here at the house for it. And that little 9.9 is an awesome little motor. Man, you just can't kill that thing. You know, it's you know, think about it like a, you know, an old Nissan truck or Toyota Tacoma, man. Them things just run forever. So, you know, that's my bigger motor that I run, you know, on, you know, bigger water, stuff like that. Believe it or not, I can run about 18, 19 miles an hour when I'm by myself with that bigger motor. That little 9.9 is awesome on this lighter boat. So that's pretty cool to me. But and then the motors that I run, you know, for electric only, I got a 55 thrust Maxim Minn Kota right there on the front. And then on the back, I run a Traxxas 80 pound thrust, you know, just to give me a little bit more juice when I go, you know, down the water. And, you know, I turn the head around, you know, so it'll go that way, you know. It gives me just a little bit more, you know, juice going down the water. So that's kind of my electrical, you know, only, you know, setup for motors. And then, you know, it's an 80 thrust, so I had to parallel, you know, two lead batteries with the wire and stuff, parallel the batteries to turn it into a 24 volt system. We'll get into the electrical and stuff when we start talking about the live well and whatnot. So, so that's the motors. Moving on to when I first bought this boat, I'll just kind of give you an idea real quick. From this point over, it was all aluminum or metal or whatever it was. So, you know, all this decking I put in myself, you know, got the materials together, all that good stuff, ran down to Home Depot and bought some 2x4s for the bracing and brackets up underneath for support. The top decking on the front, the casting deck on the front and rear are 3/4 inch plywood, pressure treated. All this wood is pressure treated because, you know, it's going to get wet. You know, there's nothing you can do about it. So like I said, this is a budget friendly build. Obviously,
you know, anytime that you're dealing with wood, you know, it's going to be a little bit heavier, but you know, it is what it is. I can't afford just to take my boat down to Tiny Boat Nation and, you know, have them do a complete overhaul with all, you know, aluminum stuff. So I went with wood. I'll pop up some pictures of when we gutted this thing, you know, in the video, you know, so you guys can kind of see how we did it. But anyway, so back to the decking. So like I said, we did the support braces up underneath, and then my wife did a unbelievable job at, and we used a cardboard, broke open the box and laid it flat. And that's what we used for our template for the front casting deck here. And then I went to work with a saw and a jigsaw, shaping it out, you know, sanding the edges, made this little piece here, you know, to make it all, try to make it level with the boat, you know, if you will. So, you know, that was tough to do as far as, making the cuts, you know, putting it in there to where, you know, it fit good and snug and all that good stuff. And then, screwed it down and all that. So, and then also all the carpet, you know, we carpeted it all ourselves. We found some outdoor patio carpet, I think is what they called it at Home Depot. I forget. But so, you know, we stretched it, her and I did, as best as we could, and then used a staple gun on the back side. So that's kind of how we did the carpet. Getting into the storage, you know, the little hinges and stuff that I did. Here's one little compartment. This is where, you know, I keep all my terminal tackle from, you know, square bill crankbaits, chatterbaits, topwater, lipless, jerkbaits, you know, you name it. My hooks, my weights, all that stuff. So that's my little storage compartment right there. You know, and then I got the pedestal seat, you know, that I put right there. I love that pedestal seat. And then I put a little hinge on it for when I'm sitting on it so it doesn't move or if I'm traveling. And then up underneath here, I got line, my dry box, you know, for my wallet. You know, I keep my fishing license in there, the registration to the boat, what have you. And then I run two Dakota lithium batteries is where I put those down in here. I got the wiring for my 55 thrust Maxim, you know, the front trolley I just talked about. And then I run a smaller Dakota lithium, you know, for the graph here. So, you know, that's where I put my batteries and then, you know, stuff like that. So, and then over here is just a little bit more storage here where I keep like my rain gear, you know, my scale, you know, some other tackle, stuff like that. Don't look at this too much because, you know, it broke on me or whatever. So, moving on to the flush mount, you know, where the foot pad goes, the trolling motor pad. I did a recessed pan right here. I definitely wanted a recessed pan, you know, so it's level to the decking. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. You know, I dyed this, or, you know, spray painted this myself because that's kind of what I do anyway. I work on cars for a living for my business. And I do like leather seat repairs and dyes, burn holes, you know, stuff like that. That's what I do. So, you know, that was, you know, pretty easy for me to do. The paint has held really well, you know, super happy with that. The mounting trolling motor, this already came with it. So that was a breeze, you know, mounting the trolling motor to that. And then, you know, moving on to the graph or whatever, you know, I just run a, you know, I used a Scotty mount, you know, to mount my Hummingbird Helix 7. The Helix 7 I got has side imaging, down imaging. It's got the Lake Master Southeast match chip in it, you know, mapping and all that type of stuff. I'm going to put this graph on the back here because I'm not even utilizing the maps chip right now. So I'm going to put that graph back here on that Scotty mount. And then, you know, that way I can have it back here from when I'm fishing bigger water
and I'm scanning around using my side scanning and things like that, trying to find fish. Technically, that graph should go back here, and then I'm gonna buy a new one up here. Not sure what I'm gonna go with. Might be a Garmin, and then I'm probably gonna move this up a little bit more, you know, just for that, you know, more deck space. So that kind of does it for the front deck. Moving on to this little rod locker thing I made here, which eventually I'm going to end up building, you know, building a box, you know, with the hinge and a lid. That way I can walk from, you know, the front deck, you know, straight to the back or whatever. I love having my rods right there with me at all times, you know, inside the boat. So I kind of, you know, I use PVC pipe right there. I can carry up to eight rods, and I may lay a couple rods here on the side as well. And then, you know, the butts of the rods, you know, I built that little piece so they sit in there. They stay snug and fit, which, you know, works out really well. So that's pretty cool. The back deck, 3/4 inch pressure treated plywood as well. And then, you know, I beefed it up a little bit, put some more support so you can stand on it, added a 2x4 right here, ran some screws in there for that. Same thing over here. And then moving on to the newest thing that we did. Let me jump up in the boat real quick. And this is the DIY live well. Let me open up this little hinge here. So this is it right here, guys. This is the newest thing that we did, and you know, we just found, well, I should probably give a shout out to Will Bishop. Go check him out at custom crafted concepts. Go check his channel out. And then his cousin Reed did all the wiring and everything for this thing. Man, I really appreciate you know, those guys for helping me out with this, because I suck at electrical. And you know, so, you know, let's get into the specifics of this thing. So all we did was, you know, my buddy Will, he had a tote, you know, laying around that he bought from Home Depot. This tote right here, I think, is 28 gallons. So, you know, it's a big live well. I wanted a big live well to hold some biggins, you know, of course. You can fit a multiple fish down in there. I've already had a 6-pounder in there, kept her in there. She did great, you know, for the time I had her in there. I didn't have her in there all that long, but anyway, so the top is, you know, your splash guard. You know, this is going to be your splash guard, and then we cut a hole in there for obviously putting the fish in. And then it was kind of cramped in here, so we added some zip ties, and eventually, you know, it'll just form the shape. This used to be a seat back here, but, you know, I wanted a live well, so, you know, that's what we did. But going inside here, you know, you got your aerator right there, and then, you know, the bilge in right there. So, and then, you know, the bilge in switch, you know, the bilge in for that, and then, you know, I got some switches back here, you know, for my bilge pump switch, and then my aerator switch. I definitely wanted switches because, you know, that saves time. We only did one bilge in. So here's how we did, you know, when I bilge water out at the end of the day when I'm fishing. They rigged up this little thing for me that works, you know, like a charm. Basically, all I have to do is, you know, drop the bilge pump down in there. And then, you know, cut the hose to length, stick the hose right outside the boat, and then hook up the positive and negative to the terminals in the back of the, you know, on the battery. So, man, it only takes a couple minutes, no big deal. You know, when you're done fishing at the end of the day, you know, works like a dream, you know, piece of cake. I mean, it takes maybe 2 minutes, if that. And then, you know, I just wrap it up and then put it, you know, store it away up underneath the back or whatever. So no big deal with that. So I'm really happy with the way this come out. I'm not gonna lie, we had a really hard time finding the right tote that was gonna be, you know, the right height and stuff. But, you know, we found that when you start going to the right dimensions and everything that you need, you know, it cut down on the actual size, and then, you know, of the live well. So if you know, I may try to keep my eye out for a container that would fit better, you know, in the future, and then maybe we'll, you know, do like a flush mount right there. But, you know, we had to frame it out. So, you know, we just went with 2x4s and 3/4 inch plywood, and then put a hinge on it for, you know, when you're traveling down the road, so the you know, the hinge doesn't fly up and what have you. So as far as sturdiness, man, I mean, you can stand up on this thing, no problem. I'm about 200 pounds, you know, this thing is plenty sturdy. You know, to go back here, and now it's, you know, even that much more of a casting deck, you know, which is pretty cool. You're sitting up real high, you know, for bed fishing, you know, once those big girls go on bed, you know, which is about to happen here soon. So plenty sturdy back here, pretty happy with all how that turned out. And, you know, so shout out to those guys for helping me out. I really appreciate that. Let's get into, we'll go check out the electrical. And I got a little tip to show you when you parallel batteries, like I was saying. You know, just a little tip, when you're using parallel batteries to a 24 volt system, you want to, you know, like I said, we got an aerator and a billage. So, you know, you want to make sure that you hook up to one negative on one battery and then a positive on the other. So that's how you do when they're paralleled, as far as you doing a, you know, a live well and the wiring and all that stuff. The billage pump is down in there. Not sure if you guys can see that. We mounted it right there. And then, you know, the hole right here where I billage water in. So these guys did a really good job. Pretty much a two-day project, because, you know, you're always going to run into, you know, the issues, it seems like, you know, running back and forth to get materials and what have you. So, but had a lot of fun doing it. Had a lot of fun doing all this, making my boat, you know, my own. And, you know, it works for me. So that's pretty much the boat, you guys. As far as the trailer goes, this trailer is freaking awesome, man. You know, I can do, you know, 80 miles an hour in the fast lane, no problem. It doesn't sway back and forth at all. So yeah, I think I pretty much covered all, you know, of my boat. If I want to fish bigger water, I got a brother-in-law and a couple friends that got bigger boats. You know, say we want to go down to Lake Eufaula or, you know, Gunnersville, you know, I can go with those guys. So so I kind of got the best of both worlds, I guess, if you will, for my electric setup and then, you know, my 9.9 in there. So, you know, like I said, this works for me and I'm happy with it. So thanks for watching the video, guys. I hope this, you know, I hope you like this video, and I hope this video helped you guys out if you guys are looking to do something like this. If you guys are doing something like this on your boats already, you know, please drop some comments down in the comment section. I would love to hear from you guys, you know, on ideas or anything that you guys are doing, you know, upgrades or, you know, converting boats, your John boats, the bass boats, you know, all that type of good stuff. You know, I'm a big DIY guy myself, so is the wife. And I got such a passion for fishing that, you know, it just pours over, you know, all my ideas and stuff pour over into these little projects. And, you know, I just have a lot of fun doing them. It gives me that much more pride. And, you know, this day and age that we live in, when everything just costs a freaking arm and a leg, you know, I'm gonna take some shortcuts and do what I have to do, you know, to survive, if you will. Anyway, I appreciate you guys tuning in. And you guys, please like and share, you know, subscribe to the channel.
you know, smash that little notification bell, you know, so you get all my future videos, and we will see you guys on the next one. Peace.